Hi, do you know this situation in jazz ballads where towards the end the soloist stays alone, the band stops playing, and he plays something magical that catches your ear, you don't know where it goes. It's like a new composition that he improvises on the spot, not necessarily based on the ballad, on the song that you just played, and it is always magical. With a lot of feeling, it's soulful and interesting. And then when he finishes, he marked and all the band play with him the last chord. In this lesson, I want to open the door for you to learn how to start playing this part yourself. We are going to take as an example the song Nuage by Django Reinhardt. And you know, it ends like that. And 2-5-1. So as always in jazz ballads, you have 2-5-1. Almost all the songs end like that, so you can implement what we do here over any song that you want. What will open the door for you to that is something that we call deceptive resolution. It is a chord that you play instead of going to the root. You play 2-5 and the root is F. Instead of playing this root, you play another chord that this is the door to start something new. I'm going to show you a very, very interesting chord now. It's a half diminished chord that sits on the sharp 4 or flat 5 or triton from the root. So if the root is F, sharp 4, triton or flat 5 is B. All right. And when you play B diminished, over this root, you get a deceptive resolution. It sounds like that. 2-5. It's not the one, it's not the root, right? Something interesting. If you take a closer look, you see that B half diminished, you have F6 inside. F, A and D, like the D minor shape, which is F6 when the root is F. So if the root is here, we have F6. Nothing special. What's special here is this note, the B flat. The B, natural B, which is the sharp 11 of F. So it's like F16, F6 with sharp 11. So the 2-5 and... We can stop here in this chord and then it will be just a special sound for the last chord. But it can open the door for us to play a new improvisation part. And there are a few ways to look at it. One way is, you see, like it's like a limbo. You don't know where you go. All the options are open for you, which this is great. So I will show you a few ideas how you can go out from here. If you have an harmonic background, it's very helpful. And if you don't have harmonic background, you need to follow your instincts, which are, I'm sure you have them, and it's possible. You need to learn how to follow your instincts. For example, I want to create from here a descending bass line. All right? You can choose for yourself that you want a descending bassline or ascending bassline. And your improvisation is going to be over this chord. Now, if you have a harmonic background, so you know this is the first degree, and this is the third degree, flat third, two, flat two, one. You know which chord should sit in each root. It can be good because it gives you a starting point, but it can also limit your options, because if you know more of the theory, you know that for each root there are a lot of options that you can use. So let's mix the theory and the instincts. For example, the first chord would be B flat. So Now you have a few options. It can be either a major chord, E flat major, E flat minor. For each one of them, you can add the, you know, tension, 6, 9, 4, for according to your musical taste. It can be also another chord, an inversion. B flat can be the third degree of F sharp. It can be the flat third degree of G minor, right? It doesn't have to be the exact chord, and it can also be a diminished. So you need to take this chord. Now maybe you make a stop in this video and think for yourself, because before I'm showing you what I choose, you said B flat, what you prefer? Major 7, minor 7, maybe A minor later, or A7, maybe F over A, it's an option too, right? For A flat, you can play F minor, F major, major 7, 6, just explore. See which chord you like, half diminished, diminished. And then you get to G minor, which is the 2. So here we'll play G minor 7, all right? But you have B flat, A, and A flat that you can explore new chords there. Okay, after you take your time and figure out a chord progression for yourself that you can also soon improvise over it, I will show you what I choose. For example, B flat major 7, F over A, right? It's like the chord of F, but over A. A flat diminished and G minor. Let's see how it sounds. For example, I will play an ending for the ballad Nuage by Django Reinhardt. And here is my T5. The band stops and I stay alone. Minor. Yeah, I just play back the chords mostly, but I can also improvise more if you want. Last chord, half tone below G, is F sharp. You can look at it as C7, which is the fifth degree, with F sharp on top, or F sharp 7, sharp 11, which is the sub 5. This is 5, and the sub 5 is the dominant chord that sits on the tritone fifth that leads to F. Some contrapunt here that leads me to the limbo chords, when I can now stop and start something new. I'll expand the 2-5 progression. Again, I'm in the dominant chords. I added the sharp 5 to make more tension, and again I can start again a new story, half a tone above. Again, descending bass line until I reached D minor. So I play the melody of the song again. Now, it doesn't matter exactly which chord I used. I want you to open your mind and just play with it. You know, for in the beginning, I didn't have all these chord progressions. You know, I just started You have this, for example, B half diminished can also be a part of a 2-5, right? B half diminished, E7, that leads you to A minor. You see, you can take it forever where you want. So, 2-5, and here is my limbo chord. You don't know where it goes? Oh, it goes to E, that leads you to A minor. Alright, you are in A minor. What's next? Take a time and you can go descending, you can go ascending. Maybe I will make A minor and A major 7. That leads me to D minor. D minor. And then I will play B flat over D. And then B flat minor, which is the minor first degree. And then I end in the fifth degree again. So, 2-5, my limbo chord. That leads me to E7. That leads me to A minor. Goes to A7. D minor. B flat. B flat minor. C7. Flat 9. And I can finish the story. There are so many options. What I want to show you is that because it's a ballad, it can be your first step to start and explore playing completely improvised stuff. Now you have the time, so you check a chord. You don't like the sound, try another chord, maybe major, maybe minor, maybe an inversion, maybe diminished. Diminished always solves all the problems. If you go, you are here, you don't know where to go, you want to play ascending, it works, diminish, you get to F, F sharp, diminish, G minor, it's part of the scale, you know it. See, now you want to go descending, diminished will always solve your problem. Play diminished chord when you don't know what to do, it always works. Alright, so there are so many options, but I wanted to open the door for you to start instead of just taking the guitar, you know, this guitarist to take the guitar and just improvising. This is so fun, and you can start doing it in the ending of the ballads. There are so many more things that you can learn from ballads because it's slow, as I said. And you can play chord solos. It doesn't have to be very fast, that you need to have to move all the chords so fast. So you can build a chord solo and play a solo piece for the ballad. You can harmonize it very much more easily because it's slow. You can practice your improvisation skills because you can play a chord. And then a chord, and then another improvisation with arpeggios or chords you think that you just learned and you want to implement. So many ideas. I show it all in my Pleasure of Ballad Chords course. I take a few ballads there and I show you how to play it as a solo piece, how to how to learn new skills, augmented and superimposed chords and substitutes. And it's always so fun to learn to do it in over ballads in a slow and musical situation. All right, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Don't be afraid of trying new chords, even if you don't know the harmony. Just show your fingers and let your ear and soul feel if you like it or not, and memorize a progression of a few chords that you can also improvise over and create your own ending. I'd love to read your comments about these lessons. about this lesson here below. Cheers.